I would like to explore with you how you see the future of, if I use the words network economy, gig economy, the future of employment, the future of consulting, the future of how enterprises will engage with experts. Where do you the consultant industry works in one way today, and we have some big American companies or whatever. We have some Nordic companies who are getting larger. We have brokers out there who's doing their part, and we have a lot of freelance guys, and we have small companies who's popping out of the mid-sized consultancies, start doing their own thing. So where do you think this whole way of finding talent and working with talent is going?
Yeah, I was just talking with my colleagues about this, and it's quite funny because we go from one era to another, and it's like a wave. So we come back and forth in this thinking. So we know all that there was the nearshoring or whatever offshoring trend booming at one point, and then they were like, okay, but they need to be local consultants, and we came to that extreme. Then there has been kind of the broker broker wave, and then again, oh my God, this is not working.
Why is that not working?
Maybe it
was what does brokering do well,
I
and where does it not
I
work?
Have one customer who actually have changed their purchase strategy, a big company, and I was really kind of impressed about that, because they had divided the procurement processes into running business, changing business.
Love that. This is interesting.
Yes,
huh?
And running businesses, and they had also written their resources, running the business, and that's kind of broker business. I think that you can find the golden nuggets from there and so on, but usually if you want to have some change going on, so you need to have a team in place. You need to have those advisors or somebody who has been doing this before, who can be your guiding light and helping you to build transfer the knowledge to your organization.
Brokering for me is also a little bit puts a lot of emphasis on the buyer being the orchestrator, advisor, and super expert themselves to really know what he wants and needs. And now going into a data platform, now you really need to know what data manipulation you're going for to recruit or to find the right, because the broker will not do that for you.
No. And that's really hard. And I love that running and changing this approach, because it's a totally different totally different consultancy work, let's say so.
Yeah, and if I have two of these and one is sick, I can ask for exactly the same thing.
Yeah.
And I can use a broker for that. Mm. But I've never done AI before. Mm. What should I ask for? Mm, a little bit trickier, yeah?
Yeah. And also the the transformation, something new, something that if you want to be on top of things. So so it has also a little bit of a different price picture. And there you can have big ones or small ones or whomever ones who suit the bill for doing the change.
But if we now move on, should companies really use consultants if we want to become data driven? What's the purpose of the consultant? Because I've seen this we use consultants as a way to not needing to worry about this. We stay data illiterate. We don't really pick this stuff up. I use consultants to tick the box. I get the solution working, but the company who has understood that shit, we need to transform into something else. What's the consultant role then versus don't you need to build this competence yourself?
Yeah, and I reflect back to that puzzle again. So I think that if you want to do the transformation you really want to have data, for example, as an asset and so on, so you need to it's a change of mindset and skills and so on. Mm-hmm. So what do you need then is somebody to to set up the first steps and the routines and show you the way.
You need someone to hold your hand or guide you.
Hold your hand and guide you.
This is good value, yes. Of course.
We called ourselves as the in a couple of years ago, the digital travel guides. And that was that was our motto then before. But it was already back then. But that's the whole point. And we believe in long-lasting relationships with the customer, but we are not there to do the same stuff over and over again. But we're there to take on the challenge first and then transfer the knowledge of that. And then we take on the next challenge mm-hmm. and so on. And then gradually build a kind of the skill set of our customers mm-hmm. to that level that they feel is supporting their kind of a core business, and that level where they think that they need to have the in-house competency, because maybe they don't have to be the champions of everything, but what is kind of sufficient to maintaining, again, to the running and changing discussion a little bit.
I like this, but let's take again, 5 years from now, mm. we are talking about that we have a skills shortage of maybe 70,000 skilled IT experts. So either way we look at it, as consultants, as freelancers, or as hiring them, we have a problem with talent, right? Mm. In some ways. So 5 years from now, what do you think the industry, is it working and functioning the same way as now, or are we evolving into something else?
I hope that the kind of companies who are now more in a kind of traditional industries or whatever their core business might be in a kind of data, but they would be more kind of skilled in handling the technology and so on.
So one key trend is that we will have a higher, you know, hand-holding in 5 years should be on a higher level of maturity. Yeah. They need to really step up their own game as well.
Yeah. Yeah, because this is kind of
recruiting these people.
Yeah, because this is kind of the problem of because a lot of kind of product companies want to become like service companies, and they need to have the kind of the skills to support that business, because it's becoming their core, because the mm-hmm. product is already so developed, so you can't kind of overdevelop that, but then you have to have the add-on services for the kind of a next phase of the growth of a company, and there you have to have a different skill set. So I truly hope and believe that companies do kind of have that kind of a larger kind of skill set themselves, and they are kind of investing a lot of money to that as well. And I think that us as consulting companies, we have a responsibility also to both kind of guide and help our customers to build that skill, that kind of a needed skill level in the companies. And we need to kind of all the time develop our own skills. Plus that like we have something, it's called Solita Academy. So we take in people that are kind of interested in a data career, and they go through the same recruitment process and so on. But we kind of pick in people who have not been working with this before, but have a huge passion for that.
As a way to basically increase the pool to meet the 70,000 demand. Because,
yeah, and this is one of my kind of key messages always, is that, okay, we can always sit here and say like, oh, 70,000, horrible, horrible, but always kind of put the elephant into pieces and start doing something. Do something about it. It's not that hard. And if everybody would do a little bit of something, so soon we would have like this problem fixed.
Yes.